my today's video is further help on remote control, as one of my friend Mr. Tariq Shehzad, he requested from Germany that he's going to fix this remote control on his one of his car, Opel. So I'm going to explain the things further, and especially where he is seeking help. So this will be a video for those who is going to install their own systems, I mean to say the remote control on their cars. So this is a channel for the DIY, do-it-yourselfers, and I'm happy that somebody is going to do the work according to my instructions. So here is the way I'm going to explain the things. Hopefully this video will be a further help in and explanation for the remote control system installation. So here is the way I'm going to explain this. Here are a few tools, just you have to see. One is the tester, of course. If you don't have, you have to get one. A simple automotive testing device, which I just made myself, this one, and you can purchase one for yourself. It's very useful every time we are using. The other one is the multimeter. If you have one, it's okay. Otherwise, you have to borrow it from someone, and later on you have to purchase for yourself. And here is this motor actuator. Its connections have some problem. This is broken, actually, you can see, and this broken is good for the further explanation. I will make explanation on this one. And here is the octopus remote control receiver. Some wiring help I will give further. I will explain things. Already I explained, but further also I will explain things according to this. So here is another tool, which is of course my pliers and some wires handy. So these things are needed to do while you are going to work on. And now first of all, what I have to do is I have to explain something in the car, or how you will find the wiring in the car, especially because it's sometimes difficult to understand the car wiring, which is the factory wiring, of course, not yours. And here is the way I'm going to explain this thing. As now you can see, this is a remote control in my hand. While the car is stopped, the key is with me, so there is no power going to the power is going to the remote control, but there is no keyed power. The key is in my hand, so the key is off. So now if I will press it, it's opening, as you can see. So it's open now, and this power had been come from the battery direct. It's not from the switch. So switch was off, and you got the power over here. And how, where it is, I'm just going to show you. This is available in so many places in the car. You can get it anywhere, but just I'm showing you the place where you can get it. Just be with me. This is a little bit difficult work. Here is a fuse box, actually, underneath. This one is black, but difficult to see in camera. And just I'm going to show you on the other fuse box, which is in the engine compartment, so you will be able to understand what I'm telling about. So here is the DLC connector. From here also you can get the power. As just I have to see whether I am able to do or not, I don't know. So what I will be able to what I am going to do is I am just connecting with the ground. Ground is anywhere on the chassis. So this cigarette lighter is of course my ground. So now I am ground, I am on ground, you can see. And the tester I have to connect to the pin number 16, and you can see just it is on. And key is off, of course, as the key is over here, just here the key. And here on pin number 16 on this DLC connector, I am getting power. This is unfused power, so you can get it from here, from this connector 16 number pin, which is the smaller side. This is the bigger side, and here is the smaller side. So the smaller side, the last pin, which is 16, you can get power from. And how to get, you have to see the other side of the connector, which is behind this one. So over there is the wiring, and from the wiring you can get, you can put a fuse over here, I mean to say the hanging fuse, and just take the power from here. Or otherwise you have to go to the fuse box, grab a fuse which is giving the power all the time. I mean to say you have to test by the tester, as I'm testing over here. So by this way, where the tester is glowing, from there you can get the power. And of course the ground, anywhere from any chassis bolt or some whatsoever, you can get the power from. So this was, and now is the time to explain a little further. As you can see, if this door lock is like this, it will be located somewhere over here. and these two wires and further three wires are there. You can see they have been cut in this particular, so they will go to the unit, to the remote control. And if it is your case, as the door lock was over here, so it will be hanging somewhere over here. As you can see, it will be a part of this door latch, local door lock, or somewhere it will be hanging over here or here or whatever the position will be. So how to test it is not very difficult. Here is the multimeter. Just I'm going to show you how to test it. So here is this motor. As you can see, five cables are coming off. Two are here, blue and green. They are of course used, and other are whatever. This is white. You can see they have been cut, white, brown and black. These are the switching terminals actually, and these two are the motor terminals. How to find them is not very difficult. If, as I know this because I worked on this design, so I know these things, so this is in my memory. But if you don't know, you can grab your motor or just disconnect it from where it is connected. So just grab your multimeter, put it on the ohms range. Here is the ohm. You can see it's showing out of limits. Now just connect these two wires, whatever two wires you have to connect them. As in my case, these two wires. So the motor wires will give you something, a resistance, which is over here in my case 2.6 ohm. So 2 ohm, 3 ohms, 2.6 ohm, whatever the reading is, that's a perfect reading for the motor. Either this actuator is in or out, they will give the certain resistance, which will be the same in all the cases. In this case, it is 2.5, 2.6 ohm. If I, either it is in, either it is off, it is out, it is in, it is giving the same resistance, the same resistance value. So this is one, the knowledge about the motor wires are that there should be a 2 to 3 ohm resistance you will get. And this will be the same either the actuator is in or out. Here is another door actuator motor, which I just found it. It's a little better than that one, which we previously explained. So here I am just going to show you the wiring diagram, the wires coding or whatever the wire functions which are required. So here are the two wires which I am just going to check it on the ohm range. So if you will check it, they are giving 1.4 or 1.7 ohm resistance. Now they are giving 1.4 ohm. So if I am going to remove the actuator from, just it is changing and then changing to the same value, 1.4. It's stabilizing. If I am putting it back, so it's the same. Why it is changing? Because there is a motor and that is running inside. So the ohm range is changing. Due to that, the electricity is produced by this as the motor is running as a generator while I'm moving the actuator of this. So this is what is the motor connection. As I know, in the both situation the resistance is the same. So now I'm going to put it on the continuity to here to give you an understanding of the beep. So here are the three wires which are not of these two. These two are for the motor, as I know. So these three wires I'm going to check for the continuity. So as you can see, white and black, they're giving continuity while the actuator is in. So now I'm going to make it out and just see it. So here is no continuity now. Now the other wire with the black I'm going to check. So now the black and brown, they are giving continuity. So as you can see, these two wires are giving continuity while the actuator is out. This is old actually, that's why it's not so perfect. The connection inside is not so perfect. But giving you the concept that it is like that. Now if it will come in, so again, it will not give you the continuity. The brown and black, and instead brown and white, they are giving continuity. So this is what is the understanding, that these are the switching cables. These are not of your cable. Don't touch it, touch them. Instead, this is for the central locking actually, while you are making it open. So the, all the wires, all the locks are open due to these two, these wires. This is the switching actually. This is telling the all the other doors that they have to open. And these are the motor wiring terminals. where the power is coming to make it lock or unlock. So on these two, you will connect your alarm system wires on these two. Look at the polarity. In one position you will be able to get open, and one position, the other position you will get close. And just looking at as it is opened, so while you are pressing on this one, this should open. If it is not, it is closing, then you have to reverse the polarity on these two wires. This is the way it's working. Further, I am going to explain the indicators to you. I have to switch on the hazard lights. And while on the hazard lights, you can see this light is just glowing. This one is glowing. What I will do is, I will have to remove its light from the inside. Came off actually. As you can see, it's in my hand now. So just dusty. Over here, as you can see, this is in my hand now and it's glowing also. So these are the two wires which are for the indicator, one side, and the other side is on the other side. So here you will get your tester. Take your tester and just put one wire on the ground. The alligator clip, I just put it on the ground in this tire nut, you can see wheel nut. And here is the tester. Just I'm going to test it on which one is the positive and which one is the negative. So of course the positive, we will go to connect our alarm system to. So this one, this wire which is underneath downside, this one is the positive. And if I will put it on the other one, it's not glowing. So this one, you can see the tester is just glowing and it is flashing along with the indicator lamp. So just it is loose connection actually. So some way like this. So this is what is your wire. You can scrap it a little bit over here. Just here scrap it and bind a wire over here and just insulate it and take that wire to your remote control. If you are not able to do it inside the underneath the dashboard, so you can take it from here. And just I'm going to fix it back as it was. So here is mine one, just put back. Okay. So here is a little explanation of the wiring. Just these are the wires. First is the pink one. This is for the trunk. And here are two wires which you can see. They are, of course, yellow. And here are two wires which are orange. So these together, you will combine yellow and orange and orange. These two, you will combine together, and yellow, you will combine together. And then the rest of the two wires, which are white, two whites, these two white, they will go to the door lock. As I explained to you, they will go to the door lock. Okay, so these. And then later on, this blue wire, this is for the indicator. And there should be a diode. If it is, you will get two wires over here. As in my design, which was the previous one, I just showing the on the car. So one will go to the one direction and the other will go to the other direction, the parking lamps or lights. And if it is not, then you will put two diodes and split it in two. So diodes are important. You cannot split it by just joining a wire and taking it to the lights, because in this case, in this way, you will join them together, and if you will switch on one side direction light, then the both will come on as the hazard light is. So it should not be, there should be two diodes and in parallel. So one should go to the other one side and the other should go to the other side from this one wire. If you need further explanation, I will be able to do it. And this one will go to the unswitched power, which is positive all the time, live all the time, and this one will be the ground. Hope this will give you enough understanding of the system and how to do it yourself. If anything is required, I mean to say, any help you need, any help you seek, please comment and please make a question. I will be very much happy to help anybody on my channel. Thank you for watching. Keep on watching, stay tuned, subscribe and like.